Hello, I'm Tranna Wintour, and today I've been invited by the Hysterics Collective to talk interiors for the Agnes Gets Hysterical. Ever since Barbra Streisand built her dream New England barn house in Malibu, I've been fascinated by interior design. Today, we're going to take a look at a series of interiors through art history, and hopefully you'll get some tips for your own home. Let's start our journey with a fabulous painting called A Scholar in His Study by Cornelis Bisschop, circa 1655. What Cornelis is demonstrating is something that Barbra Streisand taught me is very important, and that is to match your clothing to the fabrics and the furniture in your space. It's called monochromatic framing. And as you can see, the scholar in his study has mastered monochromatic framing by matching the drab sand color of his clothes to the drab sand color of everything around him. It's all a little bit dusty to me. I don't know if this is the color that I would have chosen, but I respect the commitment. Now with another one of my favorites, this one is giving us opulence. It's called Joseph Turning Away from Potiphar's Wife by Ciro Ferri, circa 1675. I don't need any of the art historians coming for me and my pronunciations, just deal with it. I believe that Joseph is actually running away from the little gold table in the corner. The stand on that table, I don't know what it is. Is that a woman? Is it a wolf? Is it an angel? And you know that Potiphar's wife in this scenario is like, Joseph, don't you dare think of stealing my fabric. That's the one that ties the whole room together. I've chosen our next painting to show you what not to do in your home. This painting has a very long title, circa 1645 by Rombout van Troyen, love him. There is no lighting in this space. This is the biggest mistake that you can make. You cannot skimp on lamps and all forms of lighting, because what is the point of having all of these beautiful objets d'art if no one can even see them? Also, what I love in this one is the ceiling height. Look at the scale of this space. Look how small the people are compared to that column. Now that is true luxury. I would highly recommend buying out your upstairs neighbor, tearing out your ceiling slash their floor, but don't build a two-story apartment, no. Live and bask in the luxury of that ceiling height. This is Allegory of Vanitas, circa 1645. Oh, this name is a tough one. Jacob van Spreeuwen, nailed it. Now, as you can see, there is a ton of in this space, all of these objects everywhere. This could be the beginning of a hoarding situation or the beginning of some beautiful maximalism. It's all in how you place everything. We are about to jump 300 years forward and going to 1914, David Brown Mine's wicker chair. If you want people to think that you are rich and living it up, what you need to do is pattern clash. Find an extreme pattern for the wallpaper, an extreme pattern for the carpet, and go wild. Everyone will think you have lost your mind, and nothing says I'm rich more than losing your mind. I'm warning you right now, this next one is a little bleak, but I feel like it's an important message. This is Paper Box Company Workers Asleep in the Kitchen by Louis de Niviville, 1961. Now you can tell this is a beautiful space. These people have spent a lot of money on the furniture. This is probably their first condo. They've gone wild. But now with the increased mortgage rates, their monthly payments have skyrocketed and they're about to lose everything. So the only thing that they can do is just contort themselves on their beautiful furniture. Don't let this be you. All right, I'm about to get personal. Kate McConnell's space, number one from Evicted, May 1st, 2000. I was renovicted from my last apartment. Yes, if you find yourself in this situation, as you can see in this work of art, there is a lot of stuff. Looks like trash in the space. I don't know, no judgment to Kate McConnell. But what I'm trying to tell you is that should you find yourself evicted or renovicted, what you have to do is leave that space the biggest mess possible so that those new monster landlords have to get rid of a ton of crap, make that process as difficult for them as possible. We are down to our final interior. I have saved the best for last. This is called Open Window, circa 1900, by Ozias Leduc. In the midst of the terror that we are living, if you can, here is my number one interior design recommendation for you. Keep one room in your house completely bare, empty, no furniture, no paintings, nothing. Nothing but the one lone window in the room. What you will do is enter this calming space, open the lone window, allow yourself to feel all the fears, all the anxiety that you're feeling in this moment, and just scream out the window. Scream at the top of your lungs, let it all out. Do this as many times a day as you need to. I guarantee this will become your favorite room in your home. I have so enjoyed our time together today going through these beautiful and not so beautiful interiors. I would like to thank the Hysterics Collective and the Agnes Etherington Art Center for inviting me to have this beautiful moment with all of you. I hope you feel inspired, uplifted, ready to change and re-energize your space. If you have any design questions, do not DM me.